अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ कन्वेक्शन। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस, लाइक इन अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द कंडक्शन विच इज़ द ट्रांसफर ऑफ हीट एनर्जी थ्रू सॉलिड मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड इट मस्ट बी नेसेसरी फॉर द पार्टिकल्स टू बी इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद ईच अदर फॉर द कंडक्शन ऑफ हीट। नाउ इन द केस ऑफ कन्वेक्शन वी विल सी दैट वट इज़ द फिनोमिना। हीट इज़ ट्रांसफर्ड वेन लिक्विड और गैस पार्टिकल्स मूव फ्रॉम वन एरिया टू एन अदर। In convection, the particles move. In conduction, only heat moves. Now, there should be a complete or a clear distance between these two terms, which are conduction and convection. That convection is the movement of particles, but in the conduction, there is a movement of heat energy from particle to particle. Convection only occurs in liquids and gases, so keep it in your mind that conduction never happens in solids. It only occurs in liquids and gases. Heat transfer by convection occurs when particles in a liquid or a gas moves in a circular pattern. So convection is a basic phenomena which tells us about the convection currents. Mostly we define this term as a convection currents. Convection currents means something is moving in a circular form or repeating some cyclic process. These currents form when heat is transferred to the liquid or gas. So when particles gain enough amount of heat energy, when the gaseous particles gains enough amount of heat energy, they started moving upward and they become more denser than the colder particles, and they move upward and then colder particles move downward. Colder particle moves downward and they also gain the heat energy and then transfer towards the upside. In this way, this cycles take place and the convection of phenomena of convection happens. Example, when a pot of water is placed on a hot stove, the heat from the stove, that stove travels through the conductors and speeds up the particles in the water. The increased particle speed of the water on the bottom causes the water to move to the surface. This pushes the cooler water down to be heated by the stove. The water that moves away from the heat slightly cools and the process repeats itself. So as I have told you before that it is a simple phenomenon in which that particles get warms and they move upward and then colder particles move towards the bottom. They get heat energy and in this way convection currents take place. As we have discussed the example of liquids, now we are going to take the example of gases. Convection currents in air, heat moves only in one direction from hot to cold. With the air, the circular motion still is present. The warmer air will rise, pushing the colder air down towards the heat, and the cycle continues. Now here's a picture which shows that how does the cold air move downward and the warm air move upward. The blue arrow shows the cold air and the red arrow shows the warm air. And in this way, the phenomena of convection takes place on this earth and the earth gets warmer.